Jordanians say they know about the controversies surrounding the Saudi crown prince. Thanks to Jordan's media, they know that Mohammed bin Salman's tour of Arab allies prompted adulation in the United Arab Emirates, protesters' fury in Tunisia, and awkwardness among some world leaders in Argentina at the G20 summit. But many Jordanians don't seem to know he'll be visiting their capital city, Amman.
Most of Jordan's newspapers, its TV networks and its radio stations support the government. But Jordanians would have found it pretty hard to find any mention of the Crown Prince's visit to Jordan in the last few days. And that's surprising because Saudi Arabia for decades has been making big investments in Jordan's economy. But so have other countries, and Jordan feels that it has to tread a very fine diplomatic line.
They think that Saudi Arabia probably is the only country in the Arab world that gives money and aid to Jordan, and they don't want to jeopardize that and put this on risk. So this is probably the only reason for Jordan to receive him in this way. But at the same time, they didn't really publicize this visit as when the Crown Prince of the United Arab Emirates came to Jordan. It was a kind of festival. But here it's like almost unnoticed.
Some believe the Crown Prince wants to take over custodianship of Muslim holy sites in Jerusalem, a role with a lot of global influence that's currently carried out by Jordan's royal family. And earlier this year, Saudi Arabia reduced the funding it's been giving to Jordan. But Jordan's struggling economy needs Saudi investment. Despite Saudi's economic influence, there are Jordanians who object to the Crown Prince's visit. Many don't want to speak openly in case their government identifies them.
I think the goal of his visit is to improve his image by gathering alliances. I think Saudi Arabia is blackmailing Jordan because Jordan needs Saudi money. But I think this is making Jordanians and the government very angry.
The Crown Prince's tour is being regarded as an effort to bolster support for the Saudi version of events in Istanbul, of the murder of journalist Jamal Khashoggi, and the Saudi and Emirati-led coalition's war in Yemen. Jordan has firmly declared itself a Saudi ally, but the official response to bin Salman's arrival appears subdued. Rob Matheson, Al Jazeera, Amman.